price swap in and of itself is not so outside the norm. The difference here is the quality of the offenses, the criminal offenses that at least Gerardo Hernandez was involved in. And to me, that's what makes it difficult. If it was all, if all these guys had done was spy on U.S. military operations and run counterintelligence operations against exiles, or, you know, do some of the things they've done, the active measures, that kind of stuff, I don't think I would feel badly about it at all. Because it's, you know, it's the president's job to make foreign policy, and he or she feels that this is a lever of foreign policy that they need to operate. You know, as a citizen, I have to respect that. It's a judgment call. I think the tough part about this case is Gerardo Hernandez is involved in the homicide. And that is what makes it qualitatively different. That I feel very badly about. I don't know if there was another way. Obviously, I wasn't involved in any of the decision making. Nobody called me, asked my opinion, nor would I expect them to. But I think, but for that, I think it would be just another day in U.S. foreign policy, except for that part of it. That's what makes it hard.
Any comment?
Oh, I agree with him 100%. The only thing I kind of have a tiebreaker here is I think this is all part of an overall deal that the government was working with the Cuban government, which ended up in all these new relationships. And I think this was the beginning of it, and the beginning of it, and they didn't call it that way for obvious reasons, because they would have left their hand shown as to what they were doing. Foreign policy, that's the president's prerogative, and I respect it. Good, bad, or different, that's his or her call. So legally they can do it too, so there's no issue there. I just think that the nature of the questions was one that shouldn't be done, particularly when we didn't get anything in return, because it was like a one-sided deal. What we got from the other side was for humanitarian reasons for kind of sent this way, which was another lame excuse that we're going to humanitarian reasons. This is a dumb deal. We got to give you these people, you got to give those. That was it. It's a foreign policy, even the person I say is definitely involved. And we all don't have all the facts as to what caused that decision to be made, which is another thing. We have to think of here, they'll say, no, they shouldn't have done it, but here, maybe it was the right idea. I don't know.
Well, and what we do know, though, is we know the Cubans were desperate to get those five guys back. And they were, to say desperate is to not do justice to the word desperate. They were desperate to get those guys back, because they had made a commitment on the island to their people that they, what they call the Cuban Five, that they were coming home. I mean, there were huge billboards and murals and whatever. This was a huge, they had to do it, because otherwise they'd have lost face.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
I've got two questions. I read the transcripts, and one part that struck me was when they received instructions for a place to put arms and explosives in Florida.
Right.
Did that come out? How did the defense deal with that? And then the second question is, I think the desperation to get the five is because they have probably thousands more that haven't been caught yet, and therefore they're sending a signal, we'll go to the ends of the earth, and we'll find a way that the U.S. will get, if you get caught, we'll do an exchange like this one, and you don't have to worry about it.
That could very well be. And you know, I mean, Hector would know better than I, and he probably can't talk about it, but I'm sure there were swaps all the time over the years that he was at the Bureau that never made the paper, and somebody ended up, you know, back over there, and somebody ended up back over here. Again, what makes this case different is the homicide. But for those homicides, we probably aren't in this room talking about, right? That's what makes this case different. In terms of how they dealt with the infiltration of weapons, you know, I really honestly no longer remember, but there was not an insubstantial amount of evidence on that. You know, what's interesting is, you know, sort of the evolution of some of this stuff. Once you sort of dive into it, as I did much later in my, you know, that Hector did, no offense, Hector's older.
No, I understand.
But once you sort of dive into it, you start to, you know, there's this saying they used to, that I read once about the Balkans, that they made more history than they could consume locally. And I sort of feel that way about the U.S. and Cuba. There's just a lot of history, and it's way more than we can consume locally. But, you know, the sort of back and forth spy games and the infiltrations and the exfiltrations, and the, you know, this one it's there, and, you know, Alpha 66 is going to go do that, but wait, there's a Cuban agent inside Alpha 66 is also an FBI agent, and, you know, it goes on and on over the years. So, you know, how much of that was really happening and how significant it was, I can't
Yes, we were agents.